Hello there, my RPG lovers, and welcome to another video. Outworld was definitely a breath of fresh air when it comes to RPGs. This game didn't have a huge budget, but 9 Dot Studio had a clear vision for Outworld. It definitely goes against the modern action RPG design, and it has a steep learning curve, which means it can be really frustrating for impatient gamers. Despite this, Outworld managed to create a healthy community and a steady player base. It sold almost 500,000 copies, which is a major success for this small indie team. A couple of months ago, we mentioned the upcoming DLC for the game, but back then we didn't know much about it, except that's actually happening. The CEO of 9 Dot Studio confirmed this on Discord, and that's about it. But recently one Reddit user noticed the number of achievements for Outworld on Steam changed from 44 to 60. This probably means that DLC is coming soon. I did some speculations in my last video about this topic, and I'm still pretty sure that we're going to get a brand new zone in the game, considering the size of the original map. There are enough zones on this map for at least a couple of huge DLCs, or we might see some of them in the sequel. But this video is not about speculations, so let's not get into that. As you may probably know, I've made a lot of guides and tips for Outworld on this channel, and I had a lot of fun while making those videos. I don't regret spending countless of hours on editing, because I truly believe that this game deserved that. I'm going to try and explain why I think that Outworld is worth playing in 2020, at least for one playthrough. So if you still have doubts about buying Outworld, maybe this video will help you. You can make some really interesting builds in Outworld, but I would recommend you to try a mage playstyle. Casting spells in Outworld is really interesting for a couple of reasons. You can't actually start the game as a pure mage, because you don't even have a mana bar. You'll need to do a certain quest in order to unlock it, and sacrifice your stamina or health. This by itself is really interesting, because it's definitely different from what we came to expect from modern RPGs. But 9 Dot Studio described the spell casting as ritualistic for another reason. Most of the spells that you can learn in the game won't do anything by themselves. By combining spells, you'll get some really interesting effects that will be useful in different situations. This doesn't mean that there is no standalone spells, but in order to maximize their potential, you need to combine them. The magic system definitely has a learning curve, but it's really engaging and interesting. I don't want to turn this video into a guide, but I recommend you to check out my Rune Mage video if you want to learn more about the magic system in this game. So if you like playing as a mage in RPGs, Outworld has a lot to offer in this regard. It's a breath of fresh air when it comes to how magic works in RPGs. When was the last time you played an RPG in co-op? Or better yet, when was the last time you played an RPG in split-screen mode? One of the major selling points of this game is the ability to play it online or local split-screen co-op. While you can definitely play Outworld as a single-player game, like I did for the most part, you have the option to play it with your friends. Almost every game can be really fun in co-op, regardless of its quality, but that wouldn't be a fair way to describe the co-op features in Outworld. The early game can be really punishing, especially if you're playing in a single-player mode. When you're playing with a friend, you can make some unique tactics while exploring and fighting. You can organize your backpack space more efficiently, have someone to watch your back in a fight, etc. Or you can be a dick if you wish, that works as well. If split-screen is not your thing because you don't have any real-life friends, don't worry, you can play online co-op as well. Exploring dungeons with a friend in this game is a great experience, so don't miss out on that if you plan to buy this game. If you decide to play with a friend in split-screen and you have two monitors, you can grab a mod which allows you to split the screen in vertical mode. I really thought that split-screen is a dead feature by now, but Outworld gives me hope for future co-op RPGs. I really wish that more developers include this feature in their games. The open world of Outworld has four major zones. I finished my first playthrough in about 50 hours, but this will mostly depend on your playstyle. There is a lot of content in the game, and you can easily spend over 100 hours. A lot of builds to try, unique items to find, and three different storylines that you can experience. There are some well-hidden secrets in the game, and that makes the exploration really rewarding. Solving those puzzles is always worth it, because they will usually reward you with some unique items. Speaking about items, there is a lot of armor sets in the game, as well as 9 different types of weapons. When it comes to itemization in general, you have everything you would expect from an RPG. Some special armor pieces require unique materials that you can find in the world. There are items that you can only get by joining a specific faction, or by exploring a dungeon, solving a puzzle, etc. I'm trying my best to avoid any spoilers. Exploration can be annoying and punishing in the early game when you don't know how things work, but once you learn how to prepare for your adventures, it feels amazing. I'm always talking about how the sense of danger is really important in an open world RPG, and Outward definitely nailed this. I was a bit concerned when it comes to survival features in Outward because I don't like survival games in general. But don't think that Outward is a survival game with RPG features, it's quite the opposite. Survival mechanics in this game make sense and they won't make your life miserable as long as you don't ignore them completely. If you have a lot of problems while exploring because you die a lot, and your stamina and health gets burned, take some time to prepare food and drinks. Survival mechanics in Outward are not that punishing as they might seem at the first sight, unless you're playing in hardcore mode. After you die a couple of times in a row, you'll usually end up in the main city of the zone that you're currently in. That will give you enough time to recover and heal. So if you think that Outward is not a game for you because of the survival tag, this might change your mind. I know that some people will instantly lose interest when they see the word survival, hence the reason why I'm mentioning this. The last thing I want to talk about is the late game content. There are some well hidden bosses in the game, and you'll need to bring your A game in order to beat them. This doesn't mean that you'll need to have a really good gear. I did a couple of videos where I fight those bosses with no armor at all, but having good gear will definitely help, because you can expect to die a lot in those fights until you learn their moveset. I won't spoil anything in this video, but you can check out my playlist if you want to find those fights. These bosses can drop rare materials which you need for crafting high quality gear. These fights are totally optional, but the fact that this small developer is even including content like this shows that they really care about their customers. There are no microtransactions, what you pay is what you get. That should be enough information to get you interested in this game, but I'll have to mention some problems as well. Not all lines of dialogue are voice acted, and you'll have to do some reading. But there are no walls of text like in some classic RPGs, so this shouldn't be a huge issue. The combat in this game takes a while to get used to, and I think it's not bad in general, except some sound effects. If you're struggling with the combat, I have guides for that as well. The character customization is very simplistic, and I know that might be a problem to some people. And that's all the problems I have with this game in general, but there might be some more minor issues. And that's pretty much it. If this video helped you, press the thumbs up button and consider subscribing for more RPG content. Click on the bell icon so you don't miss any future uploads. Special thanks to my Patreons and YouTube exclusive members, and if you as well want to become one of them, all the links are in the description. That would be all, and I'll see you in the next one.